Hey everybody, Tim Norris here, or you can call me Gray Elephant, and today we will be talking about Caverna, the Cave Farmers. Well, the component quality is really high. I mean, the artwork looks fantastic, and the actual pieces that you're going to be playing with, I mean, they look great. I mean, wood looks like wood, pigs look like pigs, but my dwarfs look like round, flat discs. Why in the world, for an $81 game, that I could not get dwarf cutouts that I could actually place around the board? Come on, man. That was a big letdown in my book. Now, if you're familiar with Agricola, this is very similar in that you're just going to be placing your people with flat discs around the board. They're going to be performing certain functions, collecting resources, blah, blah, blah. So, if you're familiar with Agricola, this will be very easy for you to pick up on.
One thing I've noticed as far as Agricola compared to Caverna is that, you know, I'll have all these great plans in my head for Agricola, and then somebody locks me out of the space I needed, and I have to change my plans entirely. And I just find that Caverna, it doesn't work that way. Somebody, you know, blocks the space that I needed. Oh, look, there's wood at that space too. Big deal. Or, you know, I can just go on an expedition or use some rubies and get whatever I needed anyway.
Now, when I initially started reading this rule book, I came across something that really got me excited. And that's you get to craft weapons and equip them to your dwarfs, and then you send them on expeditions. Now, excuse me, but there for a minute, I just had this moment where I was envisioning my dwarfs in their battle armor, heading out of the cave or going through the caves and trying to clear out some cave trolls, or maybe came across some goblins or whatever and had to slay them, and maybe they found some gold or whatever and they were bringing that back to the camp. And, well, that's not quite the case though, is it? But instead, you're crafting weapons, you're equipping your dwarfs, and you're sending them on expeditions so that they can find you a piece of wood maybe, or maybe a fuzzy little sheep or a pig. Oh, what a letdown. Okay, now, essentially what this does is it creates more options and it opens up the game more. But what it really does is it slows the game down because nobody ever knows what in the world they're going to go on the expedition and gather until they say, well, I'll go on an expedition. And then they're staring at their card for 20 minutes trying to decide, do I want to choose between a wood or a dog or a piece of wheat and a sheep? Ugh, it makes the game drag.
Crafting weapons, it might not be as thematic as we wanted, but it is highly beneficial. I recommend you put weapons on as many dwarves as possible. Expeditions are going to allow you to do things that would otherwise take multiple actions. And each time your dwarf goes on an expedition, it's going to level up. And eventually, you're going to be able to take really powerful actions on an expedition, like furnishing a cavern or clearing out your cave.
Another stark difference between Agricola and Caverna is the rubies. Now, rubies are going to allow you to cash them in at any time. You can do this out of order. And you're going to be able to acquire pretty much anything you want. And you're also going to be able to perform actions like laying certain tiles on your board. Now, one thing about the rubies is that having a large supply of these is going to certainly make your life in the cave a whole heck of a lot easier.
My concluding thoughts? Well, I'm just going to compare it to Agricola. I mean, let's face it. Agricola is even in the rulebook for this game, so that's what everyone's doing, right? Well, first of all, Caverna in one way is easier than Agricola. It's easier to feed your people, and you're not so worried about your opponents hedging you out. But while you're playing the game, it seems harder because of all the options. It's harder for me to make a decision and to just go ahead and take my turn. I feel like there's a lot more AP and downtime in this game, and overall, with all the various options, I don't make as many long-term plans, and at the end, I just really feel overall less satisfied with this game. I think I'd rather play Agricola.
So do I like the Caverna? Do I love the Caverna? Gots to have the Caverna. Yeah, I mean, it's good. It really is. And I mean, actually, it's a great game. It really is. But I do have a few issues with it. In fact, I have 3 total issues with it, and I wrote all of my issues down. Now, the first issue that I have is that it's static. The game's not going to change. Now, I mean, some people say, well, you know, but you're going to try to maximize your strategy and try to be efficient and get the most points in. I'm going to... That's cool. I understand that, man. I'm down with that. I really am. But compared to Agricola, where I've got cards and every game's going to be different, I don't know, man. That's kind of a negative in my opinion. Now, some people really like that fact, because they don't want the changing. They want to be comfortable about going to the table knowing what they're going to get. I get that. Some of my friends are that way. Totally understand. The second thing is that it feels easier than Agricola. I don't feel like I'm struggling to feed my people. I always find a way to feed my people. It's simple. in Agricola, I sit there and I start sweating bullets. Oh my God, I'm not going to be able to feed my people. And the penalty for not feeding your people, -3 points. I mean, that's staggering. I mean, you're going to lose the game if that happens. That's a big deal to me. Okay? So, Caverna, simpler. Agricola, harder. There you go. The other thing is that, let's just say, it's $81. $81 for this game is just staggering to me compared to getting Agricola, which is like half the price. I don't know. I have a hard time with that. And my dwarfs are flat wooden discs. Didn't even give me dwarfs that stand up. God, for $81. Now, mind you, this is just my opinion, and I do want you to understand that I think the game is good. I, however, struggle, is the game $81 good? With that, I'd have to say, you better try before you buy. Another thing, just real quick, I want to squeeze in. Why does this game play 7? Oh my God! Why would you play with 7 people? Why? Do you like that? Oh, I can't do that. Go with Agricola. I love Agricola. Sorry. Agricola, Caverna, I'm going Agricola. Sorry. So, anyways. But they're both good games. You know, hey, if you want to spend $81, get it. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Griffin Gaming. From new releases to pre-orders. Griffin Gaming. Enter in promo code GREYELEPHANT for 5% off your order.